Hello, everyone. Welcome to NKBA Live. I'm Bill Darcy. It's great to be back with you for our live webcast of Brave New Business. Hope everyone enjoyed a wonderful and safe Thanksgiving. I know it was very difficult for many families this year. Many of us missed loved ones who couldn't be with us due to the pandemic. That makes today's topic especially timely, and that is how we meet, greet, and connect. We'll explore this topic and the implications for our industry and for KBIS. Today's episode is generously sponsored by Deep Drawer, a digital marketing company that specializes in services for the remodeling industry. Had the pleasure of hosting B&B for many, many weeks now and very much enjoyed all the shows. But as a tech junkie myself, I'm especially excited about today's episode. Our guests are Brad Rumler, Vice President of Sales at Sequin AR, and Chip Wade, AKBD, owner, lead creative and designer for WadeWorks Creative and lead creative for Surreal Events. Brad leads Sequin AR's sales and business development efforts, providing augmented reality, virtual production solutions, system integration, training, and consulting services, which includes outstanding live event engagement. We're delighted that we are partnering with Sequin AR on some of our terrific events and presentations for KBIS 2021 virtual. We'll get to those details in a moment. Chip, who's been a longtime friend of NKBA, is well known to most of us in the remodeling world for his various home improvement TV shows. WadeWorks Creative offers services in residential and commercial design, architecture, real estate, and custom builds, and a broad array of media platforms and Surreal Events. He's also an NKBA member and holds an AKBD certification. And a couple years ago, participated with our student design competition winners in a Habitat for Humanity project in which we donated those winning kitchen and bath designs, and Chip came out to New Jersey to help us with that installation. It was a great event. Chip's Surreal Events is a digital specialist in all aspects of 3D virtual event production. Welcome again to both of you. Just a bit housekeeping before we begin. As always, this episode qualifies for one half CEU credit for our certified members, and you can watch episodes of this and other Brave New Business webcasts on NKBA's YouTube channel. As you know, we'll have time for questions at the end, so please type those in the Q&A function at the bottom of your screen. 9 months into the pandemic, it's no surprise to anyone that many interactions in our daily lives have shifted to a virtual format. Many of us had those Zoom calls over Thanksgiving because we couldn't get together. As usual, our schools have transitioned either fully or partially to virtual classrooms. Many of us have continued to conduct business from home, and it's unlikely that, at least in the short term, interactions will go back to the way they were before the pandemic changed everything in March. So we've had to adapt. Even though many of us have really stepped up our tech game, we still have a lot of room to build, expand, and grow. Personally, I was exposed to what was considered state-of-the-art computer technology back in the early 80s when my father, a 40-plus year veteran of Hewlett Packard, brought home my first laptop and touchscreen desktop, and you know, I was definitely hooked after that. But with each subsequent taste of tech, my thirst grew to the next level. It was what I call gateway technology, so to speak, and I think that's where we are today, kind of craving what's next. There's no doubt that our virtual interaction is here to stay and will continue to expand. And in fact, Chip was one of our first guests when we started this Brave New Business journey to bring an enhanced virtual connection to NKBA membership and the industry. But that doesn't mean virtual will replace in-person events. Rather, virtual will complement live events. Most significantly for us, this means trade shows in general and KBIS in particular. And we're very aware that the new virtual realities can't just be a Zoom meeting. People would get really tired of that, and no offense to Zoom, but I believe we are all already tired of that. Although I do find it interesting that some of us, myself included, have become snobs as we pick apart one virtual conference event from another. And like overnight, we're now somehow experts in both infectious disease and technology. And this should be so much easier, more engaging, and just, well, a lot better. Well, the real experts are with us today, the tech experts, that is. So let's talk to them about how these experiences will be different, engaging, and exciting moving forward, thanks to the great tech that's entered the business world in our industry. So Chip, let's start with you. Can you explain a little bit about how you got into this field and how your virtual events work?
Well, for the past 15 years, I've been telling product stories, and as a designer, doing TV shows, all of these types of things, working with brands, working with customers, figuring out how to explain products and what the purchasing journey design journey all the way from the beginning to the end looks like in a language and a media that is understandable to the everyday person, that's efficient for designers, tells the story for brands, and connects us all together in a meaningful way. Well, obviously, things like KBIS and other physical events have been that kind of epicenter central event that we all aspire to go to every year to see what's new. It's kind of the benchmark. Well, with all of this stuff happening, it really has kind of dug into what my passion set is to reinvent what is it that we really need to do to respond with current situations to be able to not just kind of replicate, but to improve upon. And that's really what I've spent the last, 5 years of my career doing, is creating interactive environments that tell the story of products. Surreal is the latest in that. In fact, we started Surreal events prior to COVID. We thought it was a great idea, regardless if there was a global pandemic or not. It just kind of somewhat seems timely because everybody else has now suddenly seen an overwhelming value to it out of necessity. So it is an exciting time. This isn't just to respond out of a need. This is a proactive invention out of passion for helping folks understand how to tell that product story and ultimately to better service the consumer.
Thank you for that. Brad, I understand Madonna hired Sequin AR for her Billboard Music Awards performance, and the performance went on to win multiple awards, and downloads of her single increased over 200%. So tell us about that and how this technology can apply to KBIS.
Sure. Thanks for having us on today. So so this technology has been around. Augmented reality, virtual studios, and so on, has been around for since the early 90s. We've seen it, it used in election graphics, for example, from the early days. It's been around for a long time in broadcast, but it's being much more widely adapted now. So in entertainment, we're seeing it more in corporate and corporate events, obviously, with this year as well. Probably what we'll do now is go ahead and play that video, the first one, and then we'll talk after that. So there's a short sizzle reel, if you like, that shows some of the recent projects we've been involved in, again, highlighting what we did with Madonna. So Madonna wanted to do something for the Billboard Music Awards. This is last year, that is going to stand out from the crowd, do something that's different. This is obviously before the pandemic, and something that's going to be a lot more engaging, get people talking about it, give us some sort of that wow factor to enthuse and excite her fans. As we said, her increases of his single went up 206% as a result, at least because of that, in part because of that. So we've seen this technology is, don't be intimidated by it. So obviously you see these big events they can be intimidating, but with also it's very scalable. So we're seeing this used in a wide variety of uses. So for all needs, all budgets, we'll talk about that a little bit later as well. Perhaps what we'll show you also now is another clip that we're doing, which is coming out tomorrow on Apple TV Plus, that we were involved in on the virtual production side.
I got a great story to tell you. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and 2020 had been rough. So Santa decided the season couldn't be merry without the one and only Mariah Carey.
This Christmas, we could all use a little magic.
All I want for Christmas.
So that shows the you know, the use of expanded sets, obviously during the period of the pandemic. It's tough to get large crews in and so on. So that's a recent project showing that, but also showing how this can be incorporated in, say, the KBIS show. We're going to be talking about that as well, and how we can incorporate that technology into virtual events, which we've seen, obviously, since the pandemic began, a huge increase and uptick in not just entertainment shows using this, but corporations and for live events and live concerts as well.
That's very cool. Can you go into a little bit more into layman's terms, some of the new augmented reality technology that will make this trade show experience so different, what it might look like specific to trade shows?
So specifically to trade shows, yeah. So we can talk a little bit about the KB show that we'll be doing. So this is going to be a lot more engaging. We're going to be having a virtual video walls. We're going to be bringing in interactivity. So you want to have a lot of interactivity with the audience. So we'll have what we call a gallery. So you'll have viewers actually seeing themselves in the actual scene. So we'll have a very large virtual set. This will be used for some of the kickoff event, the Digital Design Awards as well, will be all this, the same sort of technology you see there with the Mariah Carey show, much expanded use of the virtual space. So you're not limited to the physical confines of space or even your imagination. So it'll look much more spectacular than engaging in a Zoom meeting, for example.
I was just going to say that I got a little sneak peek yesterday of what you're about to do. And, you know, when I do the opening remarks at the Design and Industry Awards, and then to be able to interact with the audience and bring them up, and it was fantastic. I think we're really going to have an exciting event to show our attendees and members. So, but continue. I'm sorry. I just wanted to share that.
I was just going to say, it's going to be using the same render engine technology that's used on, for example, Disney's The Mandalorian. So that's the same render engine technology as also the game Fortnite is based on Unreal Engine. So we're putting all that together. It's going to be spectacular. It's going to be much more interesting. I call the little squares, it's like the Brady Bunch squares, right? Like when you watch the little nine squares. That's great for an intro to the Brady Bunch, but to watch a whole half-hour episode of little squares is not really that engaging. It's not really good storytelling. So we're going to help you tell the story from a much more engaging and interactive way.
It'll be awesome. Very, very excited about it. Chip, can you tell us the difference between the surreal reality and traditional screen share, kind of going off what Brad was saying, how this is particularly important for our industry?
Sure. And to jump off of what Brad was talking about, there's so many different technologies out that it's oftentimes somewhat confusing because they all kind of start sounding, is this the same thing? Is this different? So what Brad is excelling at is this type of produced event production where we're watching this all happen, like an award ceremony. You know, it's like it's way better than you know, just watching sitting in the audience, you know, but you're able to participate and see high level production value. I cannot wait to see it. It's going to be amazing. Really, one thing that's kind of the next step of what my real focus is on, the idea of human to human communication. That's one of the big reasons why I like to go to KBIS, why I like to go to other big events. One of the few reasons, you know, I don't just love getting on a plane and traveling to Las Vegas for my health, you know, six times a year. If you're like me, you're probably like that. But what Surreal basically is doing is allowing us not to just watch, but to participate, to be able to talk to one another, to network, happen upon somebody you've never met before. Find someone and then discover things in the space together. That's what happens in actual real live events that has up to now been missing on virtual platforms. We talked before, we're all in this kind of, you know, squared off environment and you don't know who else is there. And imagine having 100 people on a screen share at once. It seems overwhelming. But what Surreal is doing is, now how about we get 50,000 people in an environment where you can actually navigate around and diffuse away from others or gravitate towards others, set up meetings and have all of the benefits of physical events while taking away some of those negatives. That's really the purpose of creating something that's not just a kind of a replication or a sloppy seconds, but using the technology to improve upon what we're already doing. And again, this isn't replacement of physical events. I look at this as a beautiful, beautiful seasoning that can live and breathe alongside physical events all year long for the betterment of brands, event organizers, and customers.
I think we have a video to show and you can talk to this more specifically.
Sure. Yeah. So this is actually a screen share of one of our latest events that we did for a brand called Click Kitchler. Again, Surreal Events is also done in a base gaming engine platform. So imagine creating your own photorealistic avatar and now you're walking around. This is you inside the space and you're controlling it. You're walking around, you're networking with people. Other people are here, right? You can sit down at a table, have a private conversation, sit in a general session. Look at this, right? Sitting next to somebody where you can message them while you're sitting next to them while you're watching the keynote and be like, what the heck is this guy talking about? Or wow, wasn't that amazing? You know, being able to present, bump out into a private meeting where you see people's real face, present live on a big screen and be able to move around and gesture and to actually have full keynotes like we actually love, to get people in one place at the same time and have a lot of people, but make it purposeful and not awkward. That has been what has been missing. So we're doing this in a very, very unique way with Surreal. There's some other functionality that I'll actually take you guys through here in just a moment, but we're gonna continue looking at products as well. You know, having a situation where we have a lounge, we actually had a cocktail hour in full virtual reality, which sounds crazy, but it was actually incredibly purposeful. But navigation, looking at different product selections, imagine six people being in this room and you changing products out, adding them to your cart, changing lighting configurations, not in 2D, not in panoramic, but actively walking around live in the space and doing it with 50,000 of your not so closest friends. but this can also be scalable way down. So, I mean, imagine, you know, you have a salesman after an event that wants to bring in a private customer into a room and actually talk about it. So if you're good, Bill, I might actually pop us over and go through if now's a good time.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's check it out.
So what's cool about this is we're going to go to a URL. What's great about a URL is that you don't have to download a program. This is all live stream. So I'm gonna just pick a camera. I'm actually not gonna pick a microphone because I'm gonna stay talking to you guys. And let's just enter in. So you can customize your own avatar. We're not gonna spend a lot of time on this. This is actually some awesome presets. You can, you know, you can change things around. Like look at my eyes right now, right? I can change like even the size of my pupils, nose shape, all these different things. Once you have that set, we can actually even import real photography of people. So you don't, if this isn't exciting to you, you don't have to mess with that. But let's enter into the event. This is where it starts to get exciting. Immediately, we are now into a real event and I'm navigating around. So this is me on screen. I'm using my keyboard and mouse controls to actually navigate around a fully parametric rendered space. So everything from room scenes, I'm actually going to show you how to sit down and actually have a conversation with somebody. So imagine there's tons of people in here. Looks like we have a couple of people down here in the main hub right now. We actually have, here's my friend Allison. Look, there she is. I'm going to actually sit down here, fire up my monitor, and now we got Josh and Allison here. So what's cool about this is now that we're sitting at this table, this is a private audio zone. So we can have a cool conversation that's private. But what is oftentimes troublesome about a typical screen share is that you're kind of stuck and you're like, okay, this isn't relevant to me anymore. I've said my piece. I kind of want to, you know, get up. So I can be like, guys, you know what? This was awesome. I'm going to, you know, give you a little wave, you know, or a little wave. And then I'm just going to hop up and I'm just going to walk away. We can do that, which is really, really awesome. Okay. So as we're here, we're now, it's actually gonna pop back over here. What we're gonna do is look at the map. We can actually hotkey and navigate through, and this is great for, you know, going into, you know, things that if you're not really interested in having real complicated navigation, we've made it super simple for the everyday person. Here, I'll put myself in here as a presenter. Now look at this, now I'm in a full general session space. I can actually click on the screen. I can start presenting. I can sideload content, do all this type of stuff, really, really fun. Finally, one thing I'll share with you, I'll kind of go into a demo room. So let's actually kind of go into a space to look at what product can look like really quickly. So again, not just a three-dimensional room, but imagine being able to walk around. We might actually have some, I've asked Allison and Josh to teleport in. They found me. They're like, Chip, where did you go? They can just come over here, find me and teleport next to me. So now I can look at this. I can start to change products inside the room live, even change lighting scheme. Look at this. And then if I like this, look, let's select it. Let's add it to our cart and save it. Things like that. And now that I'm in the room, Josh and Allison can hear what I'm saying. So imagine being able to have this type of correspondence with individuals. Say, Allison, I'm thinking this this table set, this tile, and this appliance is going to be the perfect combination. You see what I'm talking about? We're not looking at like a gallery of images. Hey, Josh, we're looking at a much more interactive display. Like, what are you looking at over here? Oh, you like this Smeg refrigerator? I do too. That thing's awesome. You probably don't want to pay for it. It's super expensive. But like having these types of conversations is super, super cool. Now, the final thing I'll show you, you have full agenda items that we can propagate for different events. And then coming back in, let's actually just show you what we can do. I'm going to create a meeting. I'm going to invite a couple of folks. Be like, you know what? Let's sit down and actually talk about a few things. They're going to accept here. They can choose not to accept if they don't want to come into a meeting with me. But now, look, we're all sat down at a table. Look at this. Pretty cool, right? And we have functionality of clicking on the table and let's bring up a product. How about a ceiling fan, right? Cool, let's talk about it. Now, what's awesome is Allison and Josh both can see what I'm looking at and talking about and manipulating and changing from their vantage point, which that's the real cool thing. This isn't a preloaded thing. Every single user has an experience that is being live created for them in live time. So ultimately, what is happening in an environment like this is this eliminates this type of digital fatigue because you haven't figured the whole thing out in 20 minutes and then you're tired of watching it, or just saying, you know what, just play the video for me, let me watch it and move on. This really allows us to have an experience that is one of a kind, and the expansion for showrooms, to show product to consumers, for designers, to take clients into customized spaces to discuss that visual language together, all the way up to full-on live events with tons of vendors where we can walk around and experience products and stories and purchasing in a way that is more purposeful than novelty. So that's really the goal of what Surreal is. There is a ton here to see and to do. And hopefully you all will have the ability to experience an event in Surreal here in the very near future.
Thanks, Chip. That's some very cool stuff. Brad, though, a lot of this sounds like it's great for big companies. Can you tell us about how smaller firm, a small design company can use this technology in their business application?
Absolutely. So, what we've just seen with Chip is the use of avatars for doing, virtual walkthroughs and so on. I just went through myself through the process of purchasing a home and, trying to find those materials and those objects and put them together. They're trying to find physical objects. Why can't we present something in a real virtual environment? So I'll go ahead in a moment and just show a clip as an example of a client in Spain, Aidas. Who actually have, it's really that human interaction that people like. They want to trust the real estate agent or the construction company as to they're selling their property. So we'll go ahead and run that now.
With the advantages of a personalized visit, but without the inconvenience of having to visit the sales office, Aidas Homes presents Life, the first platform in the world that connects you with a real estate advisor and allows you to visit your new home from the comfort of your living room. Thanks to a combination of innovative technologies, you can interact directly with the real estate advisor of the development you're interested in. During the virtual tour, you'll be able to visit the rooms in your new home and get an accurate idea of its size, and it'll be much easier to imagine the common areas that you can avail of. A computer, a smartphone, or a tablet is all that you'll need to enjoy the tour, regardless of how far away you actually are from the development. Visit your new home, Life, and with just a click. Welcome to Life. Come in, you're at home.
So this shows how you can have a lot more interactivity and that personal touch with a human being, your agent actually showing you the property with the use of a green screen in the office. And they did this before the pandemic even was here. So as Chip was saying, is also this is something that's going to be around forever. Whenever this pandemic is going to be over, this technology is going to be around and be used even more so now.
Yeah, that's fantastic stuff. I mean, so much to look forward to, a lot of excitement. For both of you, I have a question. Programming has to be entertaining in order to keep people's attention. We've talked about that. What are the qualities of the best presenters, and what are some of the strategies that presenters should employ for the most engaging show? Brad, let's start with you.
I'd say first off, you want to differentiate yourself from what we're doing right now, which is a Zoom meeting. We just talked about Zoom fatigue. You know, why should a corporate presentation or an event look the same as we talked about earlier, a discussion with your family over Thanksgiving, because you can't be together. It should have much more greater production value. It also should have greater perceived value of the brand as well. So expanding that beyond, you know, if you're not confined to the physical space or location anymore, we can expand that to a much broader stage, a much larger environment, more epic, you know, having even subtle things. The technology's come down now where we're now looking in, I'd say, even in the tens of thousands of dollars to put some of these solutions and packages and studios together. They're not talking in the millions of dollars. You know, change it up with multiple camera angles. I say the parallax effect, which is basically when you're moving a camera very slowly and you're seeing that the background is real 3D, that really adds tremendous production value to the content and makes it look much more professional.
How about you? How are your thoughts, Chip, on that?
Yeah, I mean, the idea of using any medium, whatever technology it is, if it doesn't improve your experience, then it's basically just a shiny object, right? We don't need a divergence. We don't need something to distract us. We got so many things in life that are distracting. Just because something is cool doesn't make it purposeful. And I'm a big advocate of, if we're going to go to the trouble of making something custom, it should do what the non-custom option can't. And the non-custom option sometimes is a physical environment. So if we can add to what can't be done in a physical environment, if we're just trying to replicate verbatim, then we're not really doing too much. We're not helping the attendee, the customer, the client. That is where we really want to use creativity and knowledge of the industry to understand the purchasing journey of different segments of our business. I mean, obviously in the kitchen and bath industry, I've been neck deep in it for 15 years, as many of you guys. And so understanding how someone, you know, selects a kitchen faucet versus a sofa or a light fixture is very, very important in knowing what is needed in order to make a digital purchasing decision, which ultimately is the solution we're all trying to solve.
So we have time, I think, for at least one question. One question, Julie. Can you share the one question from the audience?
Sure. We've had a couple questions come in, and they're about kind of the same thing. Everyone's really wowed by what they've seen. I think light bulbs are going off and things are buzzing. But one question a lot of them have is ease of use for the average layperson. What does that look like?
Yeah, I can jump in on that. So this technology has been around, augmented reality, virtual production and so on, has been around for, as I mentioned, 20 or something years. In the last 2 years, it's gotten dramatically easier to use. The camera, without getting into the weeds of the technical background behind what's required for this, the camera tracking systems out there are much more stable, reliable. Fire them up once, you're ready to go. The use of render engines, game render engines, has made it much, much easier. Graphics cards have gotten better. And there's software as well. So here at Sequin, we have software as well. That's we've gotten a mega grant from Epic Games to fund software to make it much easier to use without any background at all in broadcast or even 3D. An operator can be up there using this stuff very, very fast and easily. And we provide training to get people set up on that as well.
Yeah, I think Brad's talking about some of the presenters and things that with his solution, you know, being on camera. But yeah, being in an environment where you're walking around, navigation is very important. A lot of people are very averse, like, you know, I'm not a gamer. You know, I don't want anything to do with this. We acknowledge this, and we want to make the navigation absolutely as simple and non-confusing or distracting from the experience at hand. And to Brad's point, navigation is getting easier and easier. In fact, the navigation I was using to walk around Surreal was simply my mouse click my W and A, S, and D keys. We even have things like tethering functions where you can attach yourself to another person and you can say, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't even want to know what I'm doing. Take me around and show me what you want to show me. Like, there's folks out there that are going to have that desire too. And we're listening to you guys. In fact, I don't claim to be a big gamer myself, What I claim to do is, you know, I want to create an environment that is purposeful. And I think right now these types of completely immersive, user-driven experiences are the future for events and purchasing decisions. So navigation, ease of use is important, but we got you covered. Don't be scared of this technology. Brad and I got that covered on the back end of the complexity. We just want that, you know, our feet are going fast under the water, but that duck is just floating nice and smooth on the surface for you guys. You can come in and experience. And that's what we want for you guys. And that's what we're creating. So don't be afraid to experience, to ask questions. Although it's very technical, it's actually very simple on your end, which is what our goal is.
Yeah, I think that is the main thing is we want to make sure, give everybody what everyone's appetite with kind of what is out there, but know that we work very hard on the back end to deliver the user experience that is not complicated. So amazing, amazing stuff, guys. Thank you so much. We're out of time, unfortunately. Chip Wade, Brad Rumler, glimpse into the future was very, very valuable. Really excited and looking forward to a tremendous KBIS experience maximized by this transformative technology. Some of you might remember the old Bell telephone TV commercial tagline that said, it's the next best thing to being there. You know, here we are. I think we're headed in the right direction. Thanks again to Deep Drawer for sponsoring NKBA's Brave New Business. Their marketing specialist focused on building business in the remodeling sector. Deep Drawer has also generously donated, offered to our members a free digital competitive analysis. All you need to do is go to deepdrawer.com/NKBA. Thanks to everyone for joining us today. Please follow me and NKBA on social media, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks a lot.